follow us on social media, support us on Patreon. All links in description below. When the US military released its latest nuclear posture review, the most significant weapon-related details were plans to install lower-yield warheads in submarine-launched ballistic missiles and develop a new nuclear-armed sea-launched cruise missile. Less eye-catching were discussions about maintaining stockpiles of B-61 gravity bombs, a family of weapons with a long and colorful lineage that's already been in service for nearly 50 years in various forms for the foreseeable future. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the latest variant of B-61 family, B-61 Mod 12 Nuke.
Number 5.
According to the new Nuclear Posture Review, or NPR, which the Pentagon unveiled in February of 2018, the latest version of the B-61, known as the B-61 Mod 12 or B-61-12, will begin entering service in 2020. At that point, it will begin replacing all of the remaining variants of the weapon, which have kiloton class yields, still in service, the B-61-3, 4, 7, and 11, as well as separate stocks of B-83 Mod 1 bombs, which have a much larger megaton class yield. The US military expects to finish production of B-61-12s, which experts believe will total between 400 and 500 bombs, and replacing the existing types by the end of 2024.
Number 4.
The B-61-12 has been in development since at least 2011 and will be the first in the series to feature a precision guidance capability. They will have GPS and inertial navigation system (INS), directed tail kit, and strikes along the weapon's main body similar in form and function to those on conventional Joint Direct Attack Munitions (JDAM) bombs.
Number 3.
In 1996, Russia finished work on its Kozvinsky-Kamen bunker, part of its so-called continuity of government plans to protect senior leadership in the event of a nuclear strike or other major emergency. Similar in concept and reportedly similar, if not better, protected than the US military's Cheyenne Mountain Complex, or Site-R, also known as Raven Rock, the Kremlin built it specifically to be hardened against nuclear weapons going off up above. B-61 Mod 12 will likely be able to destroy these kinds of facilities and may have hardened casing for this purpose. The hardened casing will enable the bomb to penetrate the outer reinforced walls before the actual detonation, enabling it to demolish most reinforced structures. The weapon's precision guidance will also augment its bunker-busting capabilities, since the bomb would be able to focus its blast more acutely onto a target. The B-61-11's penetrating features and particularly high yield were, at least in part, to help offset its inherent inaccuracy as an unguided weapon.
Number 2.
The weapon's thermonuclear warhead will reportedly have a maximum yield of approximately 50 kilotons, but personnel on the ground will be able to further reduce that using a so-called dial-a-yield feature that effectively limits the extent of the nuclear reaction in the physics package at the warhead's core when the weapon detonates. Some older B-61s have settings as low as 0.3 kilotons, 50 times less powerful than Little Boy, the bomb the United States dropped on Hiroshima, Japan in 1945. The US military says the future B-61-12's precision guidance, coupled with this low-yield warhead, which will also produce less radioactive fallout, will make these weapons more flexible and suitable for a wider range of contingencies than any of the existing types. Critics have warned that the various improvements and expanded capabilities the B-61-12 offers may also make the US government feel the weapons are more usable and increase the likelihood of a nuclear exchange. The United States notably does not have a no-first-use policy with regards to nuclear weapons and reserves the right to use them in response to non-nuclear strikes in certain circumstances.
Number 1.
The primary delivery systems for these weapons will be the existing B-2 Spirit and future B-21 Raider stealth bombers. These aircraft have the necessary low observable and other protective features to successfully penetrate into high-risk areas, potentially full of advanced fighter aircraft and networked air defenses, to drop the relatively short-range bombs onto their targets. B-21 Raider is envisioned to replace the Air Force's aging fleets of B-1, B-2, and B-52 strategic bombers, which have an average age of 27 years. The U.S. Air Force plans to purchase 80 to 100 of these aircraft. Scheduled to enter service in the mid-2020s, B-21 Raider will be the perfect platform for B-61 Mod 12 nukes, as it will have major improvements in terms of stealth when compared to the current fleet of bombers. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.